practice as the only advice for young artists. I used to say it all the time, but doing this little show has made me realize how annoying that is to hear. On a basic level, it's decent advice. You're not going to become a better artist by not doing art. Like, you can't think your way into making better art. Because even when you know, like, all the theory about art, you know, if you study all the theory, all your anatomy, all your videos and articles and lessons and stuff about art or comics or whatever, you have a really good working knowledge, but you might not be able to put that down to paper because you didn't practice. But as a young artist, you're probably already practicing. If you are interested in art and you're pursuing all this cool knowledge stuff, you're probably drawing all the time. And if you're really frustrated with the quality of your work or your skill level, or you feel like you're stagnating and you want to learn everything, it's really annoying to hear just practice from a really good artist. Because you're like, no, how did you do it? How? There's more to it. There's so much more to it. And there are so many different ways to practice. If you practice by drawing the same thing over and over again, you might stagnate. You might enforce habits that take you away from the direction you want your art to go. And if you practice doing, say, like life drawings, you could create some good structure to your work. There's so many different ways you could do it. You might go down a path that you don't like. You might go down a path that you really like, but it's like a roll in the dark, especially if you don't know what you're supposed to be practicing. I think saying just practice undermines all of the many choices that an artist has to make to get to their current skill level. Now, I know, like, being on the side of people asking you, like, how did you become good at art? Like, it's so hard to answer that question because there are so many choices that I've made slowly over time and through study and experimentation and, like, through doing different projects that, like, I can't muddle it down to a single sentence to tell people. I mean, hence this channel where I talk about making comics and art and stuff, because there's so much stuff to learn and talk about my experiences. So I think for me, it's very important to give more practical advice that's more specific. Like, for example, some better answers than just practice are, say, like, create a project for yourself, seek out critique and advice on your work, study from life, study comics, study whatever you're interested in. And, you know, these are still reductive of what it's like to build up your art skill, but parroting just practice isn't helpful. The other thing I also hate, and I'm totally guilty of saying this, and I think everyone is, and I think it's also okay, but it is a pet peeve still. I hate it when people tell you that there's only one way to learn art or one way to start learning art, and it's just not true. You can learn however you want to learn. You can draw whatever you want to draw. If you like working with color, start by practicing your color. If you like line art, do line art. The list goes on. If you want to draw wolves smooching, draw it. If you want to draw cartoons, draw them. It's okay to explore and try out things when you're first learning. It doesn't matter. Don't feel guilty about quote-unquote starting in the wrong place. There is no wrong place. There's so many different types of art you can do. Man, carve your own path. And like I said, like, I'm guilty of saying this stuff, because by the fact that I work on a YouTube channel about art advice, I do this, where I tell you, like, you should start with this, but you don't have to. You can disregard anything I tell you. I remember getting really frustrated, like, when I was first learning art, because people would give me advice, and either I wouldn't get it, or it wouldn't work for me, and I used to feel really guilty, because I wanted to just draw, like, anime, and cartoons, and comics. And all my teachers were telling me to do studies. And I didn't want to study. I was 14. I didn't want to heckin' study. Studying from life sounded really boring. I didn't want to learn how to draw animals. I didn't want to draw backgrounds. However, despite being a little fuddy-duddy, I still got to the skill level I'm at today. And I'm very happy with my skill level in art. And I got there by drawing stuff from my imagination and pursuing cartoons and anime-inspired stuff instead of studying all the time. In fact, I don't study as much as I probably should, but man, there are no shoulds. And yes, there are ways that are proven to improve your art quickly, such as studying from life and following art theory. The thing is, like, study all that stuff at your own pace. Do what's fun for you. As long as you're always seeking improvement and having fun learning new things, you'll be fine. There's no right way to do art. No rules. It's like driving in Toronto. No rules. So that's my rant about things I don't like. Bones brings up a fair point. Driving in Toronto, no rules. Parking in Toronto, so many rules. My cat is playing for the first time in 10,000 years. She's just knocking everything off the table. So go out there and just practice. No, don't do that. Go do whatever you want. Go have fun. Thank you so much for listening. If you have any questions, please leave a comment down below. And if you want to see more videos about webcomics and art, please make sure to subscribe. We got more cool stuff coming your way. If you want to read any of my comics, you can find them in our Ticktail store. There's a link to it in the description down below, or our Gumroad. We also have that for our digital copies of everything. Bye!